Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Matt Meyer Road to the Show series. Here in MLB The Show 17, we are jumping back in with the Toronto Blue Jays early on in the season here. We're in the month of May, but Meyer is already clubbing home runs at an alarming rate here, just like Joe Broadway and Jack Hammer.
A dominating hitter gets a call from his representative.
Oh, okay, I don't think I've seen an agent call before in my short dealings here with the new presentation elements. So we get a question here from our agent, and this is just a cool way to disguise the menu that would come up when you want to ask for trades or position switch or anything like that. It's kind of a nice check-in here and allowing you to do so, just bringing that to the forefront without you having to go search it out in those menus. So Meyer is happy here in Toronto for the meantime, but I want to hit maybe because I wanted to see what the actual choices would be when I do this. I don't want to just completely dismiss with no, I'm good. So we'll jump back up to maybe. We'll go ahead and hit that and see what we get for options. Okay, yeah, so I might like a move from Toronto if possible. I'd like to be made a full-time first baseman or, oh, never mind, I'm good for now. So, yeah, okay, at least we know what the options are in that menu. And like I said, it's a nice way of disguising the trade request and the position change request, and I would imagine something about the batting order would pop up there too if it were an issue. So we're gonna say nah, we're good, and our agent replies, okay then, but don't be shy if you've got a need. Okay, we will remember that. But now it's time for some baseball. So the Blue Jays are in Boston. You see they're 27 and 25. We're at an even 25 and 25 in the season. Haven't played as many games, but playing 500 baseball. Want to try to get more W's in the left-hand column. So you see Meyer hitting over 400 at this point. Just a great clip for him. He's got a runner at first base, and he's going to sky this one in the air. And that's not going to bump the average up any, as that'll be caught in center field. And Meyer is retired in his first at-bat here in this three-game series. We got the four-time boost going on here. I didn't notice a manager's pep talk before the game because we were talking to our agent, but maybe something was activated with a big series or whatever here. Behind the dish, you see a line out there. It's 4-0 Boston right now. Meyer up again. He's going to hit this down in the left field corner, and it's going to stay in play. A little tricky there. The wind blew it back, I think, but catch is made. And Meyer is now 0-for-2 with two flyouts. Let's see what his third at-bat brings us here at Fenway. Digging in, getting ready. Oh my goodness, we're already down 10-2 in the fifth. That's not good. Just a little ball down the third baseline that the pitcher handles, but by the time he sets and throws, he has no play to get him at first base. Not the speediest, but he had enough to get down the line and get the infield single. So you'll take it how you can get it when you haven't had a hit on the day. He's now 1-for-3 with that infield single. Let's see if he can hit something a little harder, but hold up a second here. Timeout. We got a beach ball in the field. Fans are just trying to amuse themselves, and why? Well, because it's a 15-2 game here right now. Absolute runaway, but hey, how about the patience right there, taking that one high, and ball four. So Meyer takes his base, but the Red Sox take the victory in game one in a laugher. They score at least 15 runs in this thing, and Toronto is embarrassed right off the field, and you get to see win, dance, repeat. The Red Sox causing a lot of these to be in the game this year. And there's one of them. So that's a game we're definitely going to want to erase from the memory banks and just start with a clean slate here. Unfortunately, we've lost four games in a row and are on a bit of a slide. That's not good at all. But if you're looking for a positive for the rest of this series, our last win came against Boston, and we actually swept them in that series in Toronto. So let's see what we can do in game two to even up the score in this thing. Bobby Blankenship is going to be the pitcher for the Red Sox here. You see not a stellar record for him at 3-5, so maybe we can do some damage. Meyer coming in here with 30 home runs on the season. Toronto already up 1-0 in the first inning. Check swing. They're going to say he went around strike three. I do have to say for the game this year, it seems like the check swing glitch is pretty much gone. There's a nice variety of check swings this year. It's looked much more fluid. I don't think I have any complaints there. If I see it, I'll point it out, but haven't seen it yet. Anyway, there is a double play. We have our fielding opportunities set to some because obviously I don't want to catch the entire game back here. It would be tedious. And there's a double play again. Inducing some grounders here that is making life easier for our fielders. 1-0 in the fourth inning. Toronto still up, and this one's ripped on the line. It's deep, but it is foul. Got to straighten that one out. Let's see if he can make solid contact again and keep it in play. 2-2 count. Oh, in the dirt. Strike three swinging. Throw down to first base. He now has two strikeouts despite making that solid contact foul down the left field line. Had nothing to show for it. Let's see if he fares better this time around. Third time's a charm. Sometimes it's 3-3 game. And that one's ripped hard to right center field. It's slicing towards the triangle. He's going to have himself extra bases. So there we go. Double for Meyer standing up. That is the result he was looking for after struggling here for the first game and a half of the series. Only an infield single to show. But now in a tie game, that ball is going to get away from the catcher. Pass ball, wild pitch, I don't know. But it allows Meyer to advance to third base just 90 feet away from being the go-ahead run. Toronto set up nicely here. The bases are actually loaded, and that's going to be put in play. Can they turn two? There's one. Oh, nobody covers the bag. Pitcher's got to cover that, and they might have a double play and be out of the inning instead. Meyer scores, and it's 4-3 Toronto. This is a big gaffe right here. Let's watch it again. Ball hit at the first baseman, so he can't really be expected to get back. There's one. He's got to hold on to this, and yeah, the pitcher never gets there to cover. That's ridiculous right there. What's going on? Anyway, Toronto will take it, and they're up 4-3. Little play in front of the plate. Meyer eventually gets out of his crouch and throws down there. Felt like I was stuck for a second, but the play is made. That's all we need to know. Doesn't have to always look pretty. So Meyer up again now, 1-for-3 with that double. Can he make it 2-for-4? You got two runners in scoring position. They're not going to give him the chance. Again, they did not put the intentional walk change in the game where you can just make the signal and send him there. They actually have to go through with the pitch out and the intentional walk the old-fashioned way in the game. So I don't know. I don't know if that'll be represented next year in an animation or not. It's 9-4 Toronto. Bases are loaded. That ball is absolutely cranked to center field. And oh my goodness, that was a Meyer moonshot. It bangs high off that back wall. Back by the backdrop, by those tarped seats. He crushed that grand slam. And this game has broken wide open in Toronto's favor. He had a laugher for Boston in game one. Now Toronto destroying Boston in game two. And it's highlighted by this grand slam. Home run number 31 of the season for Meyer. A Meyer moonshot, 435 feet. It looked like it was still on the rise, really, when this thing slams off the back wall. It kind of has that slice, the new ball trajectories here, as it slices away from the monster. And okay, it was coming down a little bit, but not much when it hit that wall. That was solid line drive homer, no doubt. And now it's 17-4 in the ninth. He's up again, and now he's gonna rip another hit. Why not take the chance to have a good day here, as most of the Toronto hitters have? Obviously, you're gonna score 17 runs, and there's obviously some production going on throughout the lineup, but he squares that up, hits the solid single. Now he's on second base. You got two runners on, and this one is cranked, and yeah, they know it's gone right off the bat. A three-run homer after Meyer's grand slam, and I believe that's a 20 spot on the board as Blair goes deep, and frustration all around for Red Sox pitching. Wow, that one went farther than Meyer's did. 451 for Jesse Blair. Have a day, Toronto. They get to celebrate this one, and let's see what the final was here. They hang 20 on the Red Sox with 20 hits. 20-7 is your final. A 9-run eighth was the biggie. And there you see the line stats for Meyer. Quite a performance.
A hitter on a hot streak receives kudos from his batting coach.
I would expect that after a, what, three-hit game plus a grand slam? Definitely. How are we going to answer this? We're going to go with "you're welcome." Now, let's go "thanks, coach." To which he responds, "keep bringing it." We will definitely keep bringing it with the bat here. Meyer enjoying his spot in Toronto's batting order. So we've got a rubber match of the series to take care of. Got to get over Boston so we can try to get at the first place Yankees. So we're back to even 500 baseball, 26 up and 26 down. You got Matt Meyer and Will Myers. How about that? Myers are taking over the world. Love it. Although drop that S and it's the proper way to spell it. You know what? Going on a little bit of a tangent here, but all my life, I tell people, my name is spelled Meyer, four letters, M-Y-E-R. I can say four letters. They try to add an extra E. They'll add an S on the end. They'll add both. I've seen every spelling you could imagine but the right one. It's very uncommon when I get it spelled the right way. So anyway, just wanted to throw that out there. It's been a frustration throughout my lifetime. But I'll share the spotlight with Will Myers, spelled with an S, the incorrect way. Anyway, Toronto up 3-0 in this game, and we're behind the dish here. We're not going to make a play. This ball's hit down the left field line, though, and our left fielder will make the play to end the inning. So far, so good. We've scattered four Red Sox hits and shut them out. It's 3-0. Continues to be 3-0 when we're at the plate with the bat, and this ball's hit to right field, and this thing's got some carry. When I first hit this, I didn't think it had a chance, but it gets on out of here. A Meyer moonshot to right field. Number 32 of the year, and it just seemed like a really high fly ball. Sometimes I can't tell from that perspective, from behind the plate. You hit the ball that high to the outfield, you figure it's going to be a can of corn for somebody, but this one goes over 400 feet, and as you see, he gets it up where he can just muscle it the opposite way and get himself another home run. Two in this series now, 32 on the season, and remember, we're not even into June yet. And I know Joe Broadway's had quite a run, and Jack Hammer in their respective seasons, but this is looking like he's going to be right up there as well. And hey, why not gun somebody out at second base? You're going to try to steal on him? I was a little surprised I didn't see the catcher meter there, though. How come we didn't get the catcher meter? The brand new throwing meter that is just for the catchers, which I kind of like, by the way. It looks kind of nice. It's a nice improvement on being able to be accurate with your throw down there, but I didn't get one that time. Anyway, we're still in the lead, looking to win this series. Pretty comfortable 4-1 score right now. That's going to be a ground out to third base. So Meyer is retired. He won't be hitting any more moonshots today. And oh no, a game we thought we had in our back pocket. No, the Red Sox come back. There he is, the imposter, Will Myers. I mean, how messed up is that? Spell Will with two L's and drop the S off your name and let's talk. Anyway, Boston with the comeback, furious there. They win it 6-4. What went wrong with our bullpen in that one? We should have won that game and the series. But next up, we've got the first place New York Yankees, 33-22. Maybe it's because Joe Broadway's hitting a bunch of Broadway bombs. I don't know, but we've got them next. We'll see you next time for more Matt Meyer.